Today I'm going to be teaching you how to get motion blur on BeamNG Drive. So there's two different ways that you can do this. There's one with the program that I'm going to use, and two with reshade. That should be pretty straightforward. But the software that I use is a bit more difficult. Let's just go ahead and activate my mods real quick. And then bam. And let's just say we go to the highway of West Coast USA. Alright, so now I've gotten back into position. Just, yep, 100 times slow-mo. And I'm actually gonna let this roll for a bit longer. Then, 100 times slow-mo. Alt-U. One. Two, three. Alright, and this time we'll leave BeamNG open because we don't know if we are going to want to retake it or not. Hopefully we won't have to, so open as layers. Yep, we are in screenshots, so now we wait for this to load. I have a lot of screenshots, so that's fun. Yep, there it is. So, one, shift, two, three. Alright, yep, those are screenshots. Then we do the same thing that we just did. We go to filters, this. Wait for it to load. Then we go to layers and blend average all. Okay, so okay, that looks good. See? Then we press apply. Then we go back to this, and just like so, bam, we have motion blur. I wasn't recording it. Alright, now we are recording again, so I will redo this for you guys. So, you have your three pictures, and I normally do three. You can do however many as you want. And so we can go to filters, go down to GMIC-QT, then we go to layers, blend average all, then you can see here, you can see this is blurred, this is blurred, you can slightly see the wheels. You can see the trees, the freeway, the lanes, everything is, well, has motion blur. So then we press apply. Then we can close this, then bam, you have your image. Then if you want to save this, you go to file, export as, and we are gonna go into pictures, screenshots, export, and we are gonna name this Bastion Motion Blur. You can name it whatever you want, it doesn't matter. I'm gonna name this Bastion Motion Blur. Oh, and give a second. There it is. I'm gonna name this to new blur. .png. Press export. And don't worry about this, just press export. Wait for that to work. Then you can close this software. Then if you go to your files, and you go to wherever you saved it, I saved it in screenshots. So I'm gonna scroll down. And actually, you might want to search it, BastionMotionBlur.png. So search it whatever you named it as. Then bam, you have it. So I'm as a tutorial with the GIMP software. Now I will show you motion blur on Reshade. So first, what you want to do is you find Reshade. This is the correct one. And latest 4.9.1. Select, and you always want to do BeamNG X64. Direct 3D. Uncheck check all, and that's how you don't have to go through checking all this. And then this should go through. You don't want to have BeamNG open while you are doing this, or else it will not work. And same thing goes for Roblox, Minecraft, whatever game you want to install this on. I don't know why you would want to install it on Minecraft. I guess you could. But you don't want to have anything open, because then both will be running and it'll just get confused. I don't know how, but it will. And yeah, let this load and everything, and it won't work if you don't have internet. So make sure you have internet, and if you don't, well then I don't know how you're watching this. But then you want to launch it again. Launch game. Then this way is a lot simpler, but the result is a lot worse. It's still good, but I would recommend the GIMP software, as it's not quite that hard. So then you should see this on the top of your screen. I've literally sanded down my desk by using the mouse. Then you want to press home. Then you can go through the tutorial if you want. I'm just gonna there. Then you search up motion, and it should be the same thing. fake motion blur.fx. Then let's go to Utah, USA. Auto repair zone. And then let that load in. Alright, so once your BeamNG has loaded in, you should be able to notice a difference pretty much instantly. As now the motion, you can see as we drive past things, is now decently blurred. And this is without me touching it, this is completely stock, just selecting it. It's completely free. And it's a good result, but sometimes it depends. The higher frame rate you have, the better result it's gonna be. And right now I have roughly 60 FPS, so it's not the best result, but still pretty good. Then if we go ahead and wreck, you can see a lot of motion blur right there. So, you can even see it on the steering wheel, too. Depending on your settings, there may be some ghosting. It just depends on what you have set, though. You can adjust this to your liking. I don't know if this is stock. I don't know if this is my preset, but who cares? Still looks pretty good. It's all real time. It may bring your FPS down by like one or two, but for the most part, it's real time. And then you can see there's a little crash there. That's definitely planned. You could see a lot of it there. Then I don't know what's going on with my game, but I'm getting some lag spikes. And yeah, that's basically it. It's a lot simpler, but I feel like the result is maybe a bit worse. Still pretty good though. So yeah, I will link the reshade download, the GIMP software, the GIMP add-on, because you do need that in order to use the software. If you have any problems, I guess you can message me on Discord. I'll also put that down there. And shout out to BeamNG guy for asking for this tutorial. I showed him a picture that I made with a Miata on a highway. And he wanted to know, so, well, here you go, and I hope you guys have a good day, and Happy New Year's from wherever you are watching. Let's go.